Hello YouTube, it's Anders here on Watch On channel. Today I'm very happy to present you another Spinnaker watch. So if you don't know Spinnaker, they're this Hong Kong based diving watch company just spurring out a lot of very cool vintage inspired dive watches. They're really just improving the quality from watch to watch. And actually this isn't a completely new watch in the sense that it's a completely new model. It's actually a remake or an improved version of the very popular and the bestseller of Spinnaker watches, the Breitner collection. So the Breitner collection, as we can see here, is this 60s inspired dive watch with an inner rotating bezel. So this is the new version, and they have done a lot of improvements compared to the older version. Instead of just produce more, try to improve the existing design. So you actually get a Breitner just as we know it, but you get a Breitner which is hugely improved. So this is the old Breitner, which you can find a link to in down in the description to the full review or up in the right corner. And I was very excited. This is by far my favorite Spinnaker watch so far. I think it's really, really cool, very affordable vintage inspired dive watch. So watch the full review if you want to hear my opinion about this Breitner. But the new Breitner, it has a few improvements, some very nice improvement compared to the older one. So they did improve the anti-reflective coating on the watch, so you get less glare on the sapphire crystal when you wear the watch out in the sunlight. They also improved the gearing of the inner rotating bezel. I will get back to that in a few moments. They improved the luminosity of the hands and the index. It's Swiss Superluminova, so you get really, really nice lume. So they also improved the water resistance. The old Breitner was water resistant to 150 meters. This is improved by 30 meters, so it's water resistant to 180 meters, which is pretty nice. Although I doubt it's what you're really going to use that if you're going to dive down to those depths, but it's always nice with a little more water resistance in a dive watch. And they also say that they improved the leather strap. So it comes on this very nice water resistant leather strap. And one of the things I said in my review of the first version of the Breitner is that I really, really enjoyed the leather strap. It's thick. It looks really, really cool. I like this kind of distressed look on the old one. And it's also treated with some kind of material. So it's actually quite water resistant. What we have here is a watch with a diameter of 42 millimeters. Let me just show you. So 42 millimeters, including the crown, approximately 44, 15 millimeters in thickness, a very nice lug width of 20 millimeters, which gives you a lot of other strap options if you're interested in changing from this nice leather strap, maybe to a NATO strap or a rubber strap when you go diving. And of course, also a very important dimension is lug to lug, so it's 49. So it is of course a big watch, but it is a dive watch. Maybe the most noticeable size of this watch is definitely the thickness, but when you wear it on the wrist, it actually doesn't feel as thick as it really is. So looking on the leather strap, this is a more glossy finish on the top compared to the older one, which was this more distressed look to the top on the leather strap, but it is a little bit of a better leather strap. Spinnaker says signed buckle, as you can see here. Very nice thick leather strap once again. Completely flat sapphire crystal. Very nice case finishing. Nothing too crazy, but it's quite nice for a tool dive watch, vintage inspired watch like this. So you get brushing on the sides, polishing on the bezel and on the back here. You get these very curved down, very short lugs, as you can probably sense. Very curved down, very short lugs, which actually makes the watch wear a little bit smaller than 42 millimeters. It actually kind of feels like a 40 millimeter watch, but it's quite thick, so that gives it another dimension. But it doesn't wear as big as you would probably guess with a 42 millimeter watch. So the see-through case back here, which houses the Seiko NH35A movement, which is a trusted and tried movement, which can really take a beating and which is a very affordable movement as well. That's why this watch is only priced at $285. I'll get back to how you can get this watch, which is first released on the 6th of May 2019. So it's not released. You can't go to the shop and buy it now, but you can sign up and get a nice extra little bonus if you sign up. So looking at the case back, the customary rotor of Spinnaker, I really like the 3D depth of the dial, which I also mentioned in the review of the first Bradner. So you get applied hour markings, you get these very nice, very noticeable and loom-filled hands. Then you get the numbers inside of the internal rotating bezel, which is kind of a compressor diver way of doing a bezel. Usually you will have the bezel on the outside, so you just turn the bezel, but this watch you use the second crown here to turn the bezel to set the time. This version has this beautiful sunburst blue dial, which looks really, really great. So in this light it looks almost black, very dark blue, but when you see it in the light, and I'm just going to show you some nice shots here out in the sunlight, it gets this super beautiful blue sunburst look to it, which it really makes the watch pop on your wrist. I really like the little pip of orange on the lollipop second hand, and I really, really like that they did the inverted negative date wheel, so you get white on black instead of black on white, which just makes it a little more anonymous. Automatic 600 feet down here, 180 meters of water resistance. And then you get the numbers, the minutes, on the outer part of the watch. As you can see, it's built in layers, at least three layers. So you get the outer part, then you get the inner ring with the minute markings here, and then you get the dial on the inside. This is how the new Bradner looks on my 18 centimeter wrist in circumference. As you can see, as I said before, the locks are really short and curving very dramatically down, which makes the watch wear a little smaller than, or at least feel a little smaller than 42 millimeters. So how do you get this watch? Well, you follow the link down in my description, then you sign up, and then you get an email from Spinnaker. Then if you sign up, and you're very fast at signing up, you get a free strap. So they do this amazing silicone rubber strap, and just imagine how cool this would look. This is a 22 millimeter. I will get back with a full review of the Spinnaker strap. They have made a strap program, but it has a value of $50 US. So if you sign up for the new Bradner watch, then you'll get this free strap. It comes in a lot of different colors, and I don't know if you can choose which color you want, but then you can actually get this very nice tropical rubber strap with the watch, so you can change between the leather strap and the rubber strap, which is really, really nice. So you sign up, and then on the 6th of May, the watch is being sent to you. So this was my full review of the new Spinnaker Bradner, just also very shortly compared to the old Bradner. I enjoy both versions, and now I'm really happy that I got this kind of black and the sunburst blue, so I can just choose between which kind of version I want during this summer. But for less than $300 US, you get a very, very nice, very fun, and very well built vintage inspired dive watch, in my opinion. If you enjoyed this video, leave me a comment down below, give me a thumbs up, follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and remember to see all my other watch reviews here on my channel, Watch On Channel. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.